Welcome to Fight Night Street Fighter Edition, featuring some of the top players from around the world. With $25,000 in prize money on the line, who will go home the Street Fighter champion? This is Fight Night.
Hello everybody and welcome to Fight Night. It's time to begin our Street Fighter series as once again we've gathered the top 8 players from around the world for a chance at glory and up to $25,000 in prizes. As we get ready for our introductions, we have a video to explain to you just what Street Fighter is all about.
Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition is a 1v1 cult fighting game developed by Capcom and Dimps. Choosing one of 39 characters, players fight to the finish until their health bars are completely drained. There are two possible ways to attack in Street Fighter: punches and kicks. Using these moves with your joystick at the same time activates abilities or combos that can deal significant damage. At the highest level of competitive play, Street Fighter's extremely quick pace not only requires top players to be fast with their hands, but also requires them to take out opponents with mind games. Those who outmaneuver and outthink their opponents will be the champions. So here's the rules for Fight Night Street Fighter. 8 world-class players are chosen at random by the heartless ESGN TV wheel. They are going to battle each other over 7 brutal matches until we have the last man standing. But the stakes are high. Players can win from $500 right up to $25,000.
Yo, what's up, guys? It's Tasteless here for Fight Night Street Fighter Edition. I'm here with my homie Gootecks. What's up, dude?
Doing all right, Tasteless. First time casting together?
Yeah,
I know. Is this the StarCraft studio, man? Are we in Korea?
You are not lost, my friend. I am here actually casting Street Fighter instead of what I'm normally doing, casting StarCraft. I wanted to do this for a long time, but there just were never any Street Fighter tournaments in Seoul that I was able to do.
Well, today's your lucky day, because we got 8 of the best players from all around the world here to compete tonight for you guys.
Yeah, let's see what these guys are all about.
My name is Hajime Taniguchi. My nickname is Tokido from Japan.
My name is Ryan Hart. I'm from the UK, and my handle is Prodigal Son.
예, 반갑습니다. 한국에서 온 이선우라고 하고요. 닉네임은 Infiltration이라고 하고 있습니다.
My name is Ho Kun Xian. I'm from Singapore, and my ID is DM Macheads Xian.
So I'm Alioune Camara. I'm from France, and I'm playing for a team Barcelona Esports.
My name is Mike Ross. That's my gamer tag, and I'm from Los Angeles, California.
My name is Olivier. My nickname is Luffy. I'm playing Street Fighter 4, and I'm coming from France.
So guys, my name is Ryan Ramirez, aka Complexity Filipino Champ. I'm from San Francisco, California.
I'm not one to really sort of boast pre-match, I'm going to do this and that. No, we'll see what happens, and I say let the best man win, really.
Even when I win, I'm trying to do better. So I'm like a perfectionist.
They are all very good, very skillful players, so it's going to be hype.
A lot of really good players here, man. I have no idea who's going to win. I'm personally rooting for Infiltration. I love seeing the Koreans dominate in any esport, especially because that's where I'm out there working. So I'm hoping he does well here today.
Yeah, we got last year's Street Fighter 4 world champion, and we also have the current reigning world champion of Street Fighter 4, Xian, as well as the second place finisher at EVO, Tokido, in the house. So those guys have very strong chances of doing very well tonight. And we also got the People's Champ, Mike Ross, in the house, as well as the 2012 Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 champion, Filipino Champ.
Yeah, and a great Dalston player as well. Now, all of our players here are selected at random. So we're gonna go to the wheel and see who that first player is going to be.
Thanks, guys. That's right, it's time to pick our first player. So Sandra, please spin the wheel and let's find out who our first player is.
All right, it's time. Who's it gonna be?
Very strong spin by Sandra.
Absolutely.
It's a good thing that they had her spin the wheel instead of one of these guys, because these guys have actually been practicing their wheel spinning technique. Who's it gonna be? It's not gonna be Infiltration. Nope, there goes Filipino Champ. Oh, it's gonna be Alioune.
No.
Oh, it's gonna be Mike Ross.
Mike Ross.
All right. So, hey, it was fate. It was fate. It was meant to be.
Mike, you ready?
Okay. All right, Mike. Now Mike is gonna go over here to the wheel, and he's gonna spin to determine who he's gonna fight first.
This sets the tempo.
Yeah, this is going to set the pace for the entire thing. Mike, have you practiced your spinning technique at all?
Ready?
I've been practicing, but do you see all those mad faces over there right now?
Yeah, they're so salty. Look at these guys. They're so mad.
Oh, that's salt
mad.
Right there.
Mike, before we go and spin, I want to ask you one thing. Is there any person that you want to land on right now?
I'm really hoping that I land on Filipino champ.
Oh, yes. Oh.
All right. Well, actually, before you spin, we have to remove you because there's no Mike Rosses left, unfortunately. There's only one. And so we can put another player in, but as a result, when you put an extra person in, that person gets a $50 extra call-out bonus. Who's it going to be?
It's going to be Filipino champ.
All right, so let's load up the wheel.
Yeah, let's put it like this. I'm a competitive player. Everybody else here is a competitive player as well. I know where I stand in terms of skill against some of the other guys here. So I hope I can use the wheel to my advantage and win this with wheel skill, you know? let's bank on that.
All right, Mike, it's time to find out who your opponent's gonna be. We have two F champs and one of everybody else. Take it for a spin.
Here we go.
All right, and it's going round and round. The wheel goes where it stops. Even Mike Ross does not know.
FJM, stand up. He's ready.
He's waiting for it. Is it going to happen? It's still going too fast. All right, it's starting to slow down here.
Let's go, Mike.
We got Filipino champ on opposite sides here, by the way.
Oh, God.
It's getting slower.
Oh, God.
Oh, you know what? You know what? I think it's actually going to get on. Look. Oh my God, is it gonna be Taquito? No, it's still going. Oh my God! And Ryan Hart, it's going to Ryan Hart. Okay, it's happening.
It's okay.
I have the option to walk away now with what I got, right?
Well, actually, Mike, you have two lifelines. One was to remove a player off the board and fill it, but you also have an option to re-spin if you feel like you want to get a different opponent other than Ryan Hart. But if you use it, you can't use it in later rounds.
Dude, use it. Use it. You have to use it. You have to use it. Because you have to use it.
I'm thinking that if I play Mike Ross, things will hopefully be okay because I feel that my Honda knowledge, which I'm assuming he's going to pick Honda, I think my Honda knowledge is good enough to be able to beat him.
I said there's one person I did not want to play this event, and I did not want to play Ryan Hart, so I'm going to have to go for the respin.
All right, so here we go. Try number two. I hope you get Ryan Hart again. Why don't you want to play Ryan Hart?
Because I have had the worst luck playing against him in all my matches.
Well, Ryan over there is looking a little slighted because I think he was ready to go.
I know he was ready to go. I have to look out for my best interests.
Absolutely. So here we go. Try number two. Your respin is used. Let's see what you get.
Here we go. Oh.
Okay.
All right.
It was a really smart move by Mike to respin because he knows that it would be next to impossible for him to beat Ryan Hart. And this is the thing. There's no guarantee that he would win the match, so you might as well just use the lifeline
early.
Yeah,
it makes sense. Yeah, use the lifeline.
Use the lifeline early.
He said he didn't want to play against Ryan Hart. Okay, he's going to try to get out of that again here. And it is slowing down.
He's got a chance, boy. He's got two
chances.
He
barely ended up playing Filipino champ last time. And it it is starting to slow down.
Yeah,
okay,
I mean,
but we're passing Tokido. Now we're going to loop the
other
guy.
Oh, God.
Is it going to stop it, Ryan Hart?
Oh, God.
Oh, it's so close.
God.
It's going to be.
Wow. It's Xian. Any thoughts?
Well, I talked a lot of trash about him on my interview, so we're about to see if I'm going to back it up right now.
Well, Xian is an Evo champion. He won this past year. You know, I first met him in 2011, and I felt like it was kind of cool as being like one of the first people outside of the US to like really see and discover this dude. And we were told about him, like, yo, this is the best player in Singapore. You gotta play against him. And the dude was really good. So I played him out there. I mean, he's not in the room right now. Yeah, I bodied him. Like, it was bad. You know, I'm just way better. I still feel I'm better than him. And that's just real talk. but he's a nice guy.
Mike Ross, don't really face that in tournament. But I've never beaten him. I've never seen him in a tournament because he usually get wiped out before I can even see him. So Yeah, I look forward to playing him in Germany, definitely.
See you after the break for more Fight Night. We hope you prepared for more Fight Night.
Oh my God, this is a sick matchup, man.
I can't believe what the Wheel of Fate has decided for us today.
Yeah, I mean, look, Mike Ross, he said no to Reinhardt. You can't blame the guy.
Yeah.
But to be against Xian.
Yeah, okay, so basically, I would say that Mike actually has a better chance against Xian than he does against Reinhardt, because Reinhardt basically owns Mike's soul. But, you know, Mike and Xian have played, you know, they play a lot of casuals. They don't typically play a lot in tournament, but, you know, they know each other very well. So I think we're going to see a very interesting fight here.
And I can't wait any longer. Guys, go ahead and shake hands. I want a fair fight. Actually, no, I don't. I want this to be pretty salty. Go ahead and plug in here. And we're going to begin this setting the pace.
This sets the pace of the entire...
how Fight Night is going yes. to unfold here.
This could change the fate of Street Fighter forever. We'll see how it goes.
You know what else is crazy about this is that... Xian is, I would say, so strong right now. I mean, Evo champion.
Yeah.
And think about this. If he can keep the momentum going here and keep winning,
he could be
he could make a lot of money, Gootecks.
Oh, yeah. Xian could be up. Either of these guys at this point could be up 25 grand.
All right, so. We're here now. We got Mike Ross going with E Honda. He's got a fantastic E Honda. But Jen, this is what this is the player that actually was used. The character that was used for Xian to actually become the champion that he is now.
Correct. Yeah, Gen is considered not top tier, but kind of secret top tier by certain top players because he has two very distinct fighting styles that he can switch between at any time.
And Jen is taken out there. At the start of that, pretty convincingly there by Mike Ross. Let's see if he can keep this going right now. We're going into the next match up here. And again, it's going to be first to seven wins. So there's still anything could still happen here. All right, so right now, Jen continuing to poke in here. Jen is not a commonly played character. So it makes it pretty tricky, especially considering Mike Ross has very little experience at all against Jen here.
Yeah, so now Honda's stuck in the corner, and this is not where you want to be. But,
wait!
Xian makes a critical error. Mike uses his super, and now it looks like he is going to take this first game.
What is happening
here? So game one goes to Mike Ross. Game one goes to Mike Ross. And now we're going to start game two. They are playing first to seven wins.
Yeah.
And so Mike is looking pretty strong here. He's going to have some momentum. You can see that all the players in the background want Mike to win.
You guys want Mike to win back there? It would be better for some of you guys, you think, right? Is anybody here willing to bet on Mike Ross, though, right now?
Okay, there we go. Filipino champ has got some money.
You want to bet with him? Yeah. I'll bet on Mike Ross right now because... Because I got a lot of money exchanged at the airport.
Yeah, got that esports StarCraft money.
All right. So we got this. We got right now Honda low on health here, but he's Mike Ross has been doing a really good job so far. I'm actually surprised at that first one. I thought this could have just been a 4-0 to be honest.
Yeah, no, it's okay. Mike can hold his own against anybody in the world. People don't like to give him credit because maybe he doesn't have like the. His highest tournament placing was fourth place at Evo in 2010. And so a lot of people discount him for that. But Mike is actually a very strong player that can hold his own against anybody.
Now we got Honda in the corner here.
Yeah, so all Xian has to do at this point is basically just play it safe and don't take any huge risks. And he should be able to close out this round. He does have full super and ultra, but he's not going to use any of his meter because he wants to save it for the second round. So for those that are new to Street Fighter, the ultra meter builds up, which you'll see on the side next to the super meter. It builds up every round, and so you don't have to worry about necessarily saving it for the next round because it starts over. But the super bar is actually what you really need to look out for. That's their resources. So, if you're down in life in that sort of situation, you don't necessarily want to use your resources because you're probably going to die anyways. So you'll see that both of them saved it for this next round.
Like you said, yeah, it's all about economizing that super bar and ultra bar and how you balance that out in a series like this. So we got Honda now getting juggled into the corner.
And let's see where Jen takes it from here, actually trying to cross him up there. Now Jen in the corner here. So far, you know, Mike's done a very good job with some of his zoning here.
Yeah, but you'll see right there. Yeah, so Xian uses up his super right there, and now Mike, even though he has full super and full ultra, this is going to be tough for him to come back from. And, there we go. Smart stuff. We'll see if Xian blocks here.
I don't know if he can actually pull a rabbit out of his hat here. No,
yeah, that's
okay.
Xian ties it up 1-1. So now it's one game apiece. The score is tied.
Yep, so we're going into game three here.
Yep.
And, you know, I'm starting to wonder if, you know, if Xian's kind of starting to get Mike Ross's numbers here after playing him a little bit.
Mike is off to a very strong start, has him in the corner working on a perfect.
Yeah,
but
actually.
We'll see if Xian is going to, oh wow.
Oh my God.
Xian is playing
so
safe
right now. Is he gonna get a
perfect? Xian is playing so safe, he's just blocking. Oh, wow, Mike Ross gets,
oh yes.
All right, infiltration likes that one. So, Mike Ross working on winning game two here. This is definitely an uphill battle, but you know, Mike is looking very strong. He didn't come all the way across the world to lose in this first round.
No, man, and if he wins this, that's gonna change
the dynamic of everything. Oh yeah, absolutely.
Right,
see, you'll see all the players behind him cheering for Mike because they know that Xian is technically the stronger player. I mean, this is the reigning world champion.
Boy, are we gonna have a counter perfect here?
It's possible.
It's possible.
Oh, no,
not yet.
We'll see if he uppercuts right here. No, okay, yeah, all right, there we go. That's the uppercut that I was talking about. So Mike is still, he's ahead on meter. So, there we go. He misses EX headbutt, but it looks like Xian is about to close out this round. But all now right, Mike has got a full bar to work with. Okay,
all
that's
right,
fine.
So yeah, we're going to go to the next one here.
Yeah,
but he does have full super bar here, which is going to be helpful going into this match with just two bars here for Xian right now.
Yeah, so now you'll see Honda has his chop, standing fierce. He can cancel that into super on reaction. So he can see it and then do super, and that does a lot of damage. So that's actually something to look out for here when Honda has full super meter.
Okay, he's taking some more damage. This is going to connect here.
Okay, now Mike has such a large life lead right here. All he has to do is basically play it safe. Oh no.
Wait.
Oh wow, Xian missed it.
Did not connect.
Oh man, Mike couldn't capitalize. That was a huge loss for Xian, throwing out that super and having it not connect. But now they're both at about even, and neither one of them have meter. Okay, now Mike's got one bar. That means when Honda has one bar, he can use EX headbutt to get Xian off of him. So if he gets knocked down and then Xian is on top of him, Honda can just do EX headbutt and then reset the situation. And there we go. See, Mike,
he's getting very low right now.
See, now Honda has a huge advantage because all he has to do is wait for Xian to make a mistake. Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Oh my God.
See, Filipino champ getting very excited. Infiltration also cheering for Mike Ross. Now the score is 2-1, Mike.
Yeah. I guess so far these results are actually pretty surprising.
Hey, only here on ESGN Fight Night, right?
Yeah, man, seriously.
The Wheel of Destiny
has brought us here.
Yeah, look at...
And look, again, he's doing such a good job of doing that chip damage there.
Yeah, Honda does so much chip damage with the 100 hand slap.
Yeah, 100 hand slap.
Mm-hmm. But now Xian is applying the pressure here. This is not where Mike wants to be, but there we go. There's that EX headbutt. He can hit ultra right there. So the thing about Xian is that because he can switch stances with all three punches and all three kicks, that gives him two ultras instead of one. So he can switch stances at any time because he has different moves for different situations.
Okay. Ooh. Oh, nicely done there. That poke in there, taking out Honda. And now we're going to go.
So now they're both. Oh no! All right.
Well, actually, even Gen's ahead in super bar right now. But
yeah, exactly. So, you know, the life bar is not always as important as the super bar because if you have lots of life but no resources, and your opponent is like down on life but he has lots of resources, he can do a lot more damage and tie it up quite quickly. So you'll see right now, Xian has super, which means that, and now he has ultra, and he can connect his ultra after the super.
Okay, nicely done here.
Okay, nice read by Mike doing the jumping back
missing that grab.
Yeah. That's actually kind of like the Mike Ross special, where you'll see him do the 100 hand slap, and then FADC, he'll cancel it into the dash in, into the command grab.
Yeah.
So that's something that Mike basically invented that.
That's his style.
Yeah,
right
that's
there.
His. That's all him. Oh, right there. Oh. And then Xian missed a huge opportunity. Okay, yeah, he didn't miss it that time.
Okay,
but he missed an opportunity when he hit him air to air. He missed the opportunity to land his ultra and end the round. But it didn't really matter since he got another opening anyways. So now the score is tied up.
Yeah, 2-2 right now. Remember, it's first to seven wins here.
Right. So both of these guys definitely playing it very safe, you know. There's no reason to take a lot of chances this early in the set. And you'll see Mike, he'll get an opening like that, and then he'll just kind of sit back and wait for Gan to come to him and make a mistake. And then he'll use his EX headbutt to get out of trouble like that. But Xian was able to catch him anyways. And now Mike has got his back to the wall here.
Yeah, he's coming in here pretty hard right now, totally cornered.
Yeah, I mean, the ability to fight in the corner and stay patient is definitely the mark of a strong player, because
absolutely.
Lots of players will panic in the corner, you know, they'll take more risks to get out. But if you feel confident that you can sit there and block, What was that? Okay, all right.
Well, I think he's trying to build a bar by doing that grab,
okay.
And then he actually connected that in there with that ultra.
Oh, that's okay. Yeah, Mike's not happy about that one.
Yeah, Xian just looked at him
and smiled. Yeah, so Mike was back there trying to build meter, but
the
command grab.
He's trying to build meter, yeah. The guy detects it and says, no, you got to respect
exactly.
my ultra when I got that.
Yes, exactly. Street Fighter is a game of respect, you know what I mean? Because there's so many situations where it's like, well, would he do that on Wake Up? Would he, or does he respect me enough to let me get up?
Okay, we have him now closing in over here. All right, and once again, Mike getting close to the corner. He's been doing a really good job with those headbutts to try to push out there.
Yeah, see, in this situation, you know, it can be a difficult match for Gen because
Is it going to happen again?
Really? From full screen?
Oh, my God.
Okay, that's okay. See, that's okay. Mike looks at him and he can't believe it. But the thing is, look at Mike, now Gen has no bar. He has no ultra.
That's true.
And no
that's
super.
True.
And Mike has his ultra and the life lead.
Yeah,
and the
and
meter.
And Honda's already got so much life as it is. So.
Right. Oh, okay. Well, okay.
Wait,
so Xian baited him out right there.
But he still has ultra in the two EXs. Okay, one EX headbutt burns out now. He could build up to a second one, but
there's not
a lot of room here.
I think Mike was trying to do the command grab to build meter again because he wanted to see if Xian could punish it with super. So he was testing him. But now that he knows that he can't do it, I'm pretty sure that he'll make the adjustment and he won't do that anymore. So that game was basically like a test. So now the score is 3-2.
3-2.
Xian. We'll see what kind of adjustments Mike can make to his game. He's still doing very well.
No, he's doing very well considering what he's up against right now.
Mm-hmm.
All right, nicely done there by Xian.
Yeah, so Gen's whole game plan revolves around getting the hard knockdown. The difference between a hard knockdown and a regular knockdown is a hard knockdown, you cannot do a quick get up, which means that the timing for when you're gonna get up is always gonna be the same. So Gen, as a character, wants to get the hard knockdown so that he can do an ambiguous cross-up. And an ambiguous cross-up is where you're not quite sure which way to block.
It looks like now he's managing to get him again here. Complete beatdown right now. Let's see if Mike Ross sort of turns around. He tried that EX headbutt and got punished for it, but not entirely punished.
Yeah, so now Gen, because he has the lead and he knows that Honda has to come to him, he'll be patient and just try to get in small minor hits and chip damage
some
like that.
There, like, mm-hmm. yeah.
So that way...
He might just try to chip him out here.
Yeah, but see, at the same time, because he's playing patient, he's allowing...
Oh, nicely done.
Yeah, he allows Mike to build more meter. So Mike takes advantage of the situation, knowing that Xian will play conservatively in order to build the meter for this round. So now... okay, there we go. See, so... He'll use it right there, but then you'll see that Xian will use Gen's uppercut to build meter himself. Oh, not a good place to be. Not a good place to be for. But Mike gets out of the corner.
Yeah, now he's actually going to go ahead and try to shove Gen back in the corner here, chipping
now,
with a 100 hand slap.
Yeah, but he's got to be very careful because Gen has both super and ultra stocked. So if he gets one opening, that could. He's not going to be able to end the round with it.
Oh.
But it will give him a significant life lead.
Uh-oh. Oh,
not
nicely
looking good here
done.
For Xian.
Okay.
He's got to do something.
Okay, now underhand slap again here to continue to chip.
Mike still, okay, now that the sequence is over, so now Mike can just basically play very conservative. There we go.
Nicely
and just wait
done.
For him
that
to make a mistake.
Bouncing him back.
Yeah. So now, last round, both players have full super, so we'll see Xian try to stick out those little pokes. Oh, there we go. And he uses, see, that was not a smart move by Mike, but he gets out of the corner, and now Xian actually, he did a lot of damage, and he's got a solid life lead, but he is out of meter.
All right. Yeah, and you make a good point, you know, back there, but hold up, thought we have super built up now here.
Yeah, so
and,
now.
And if he can get the ultra, the super off to connect here, or even just use a few EX headbutts to do enough damage, mm-hmm. he can still pull this back.
Yeah, exactly, because he doesn't necessarily need to use his full super bar. Just because you have the full super doesn't mean that you shouldn't use your EXs. It, you know, obviously every situation is different, but Mike knows that if he would have hit the super at that point, Xian would have still been alive, so he would have still had to have finished him off in some way without any resources.
Oh, nice EX headbutt, knocking him back. Xian gonna try to come in here, maybe try to get a poke or two off.
Yeah, but even if he does, oh. Okay, all right,
I've got to throw life very close right now.
Okay, safe jump. Sometimes, okay, so depending on the timing, Xian can jump in and.
Oh, that
even
was
if
close.
Mike, even if Mike does EX headbutt, he'll be able to block if he times it properly.
Oh,
Mike ties it up. Three games apiece.
What is happening?
Infiltration, very happy about that one. Mike takes a breather to let everybody know.
Stay tuned for more Fight Night. Welcome back to Fight Night.
Maybe Filipino Champ has some words for Mike.
Any advice for Mike right now, guys? I know you guys want him to win right now.
Filipino champ says he's got to play solid the entire time. I think Mike's done a really good job of holding his own against the world champion. Filipino champ?
Yeah, I feel like he needs to play more solid and not crack, you know, under pressure. Because usually this is the turning point. If Mike Ross is going to beat a world champion or lose 0-2 in tournament.
Yeah.
So he's up there, definitely.
All right, in this game right here, we already see Mike Ross's Honda is very low here. I expect him to lose. He might try to build a little bit more bar so that he's in better shape when he goes
right
to the next part of this round here.
So lots of times, you know, you could sit around and just try to, like, somehow find an opening and grind him out and win the game. But lots of times, it can be better to just be like, all right, well, I'm just going to try to build a little meter, and I'm just going to save my juice, my mental energy for the next round.
Yeah, yeah.
Because sometimes it's like you don't want to throw, like, good mental cycles after bad, you know? And now you'll see it's actually working out in Mike's favor because he was able to build some meter in the last round, and he does have the life lead now in this round.
You got to keep in mind, too, though, like, let's say he builds all that meter for now and he wins that, he might have no meter in the third part of
right.
this
and
round
that's,
here, which is another problem as well.
Yes, exactly. You definitely don't want to start the third round with no meter, especially if your opponent starts with full bar.
And as we can see now, Xian's still pretty low on health here. Oh.
Yeah, but Mike's doing a good job. Playing really good defense here, you know. I mean, if you think about it, right? Like, of course, a sumo wrestler would, you know, you would have to come in on him and he would have very solid defense, you know, in a real fight.
Yes.
But now Mike doesn't want to go too hard right here because, again, if he...
Oh, is that going to connect? It does.
Okay. Well, that's okay. So now Mike knows that if he does the headbutt from that distance, that Xian will be able to reversal super and then connect that into ultra. He may not have known that, but now he knows.
Now he knows,
yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, so now it's all, okay, so now, Xian has regained the lead 4-3. And these guys are playing first to 7 wins. So, you know, Mike has got to continue to play solid, play good defense. Oh,
ooh,
no.
Nice focus there. Really beating him up in the corner now. And I gotta say, I feel like Mike Ross has been playing well. I feel like some of that momentum's starting to go away a little bit.
Yeah.
You can start to feel it in some of these games.
Right, so right there, Xian did a wake-up uppercut. That was the first wake-up uppercut that he did of the set. So we'll see what sort of adjustments these guys are going to be making.
All right, Jen now in the corner here, but he's doing a great job pushing back Mike Ross's Honda right now.
Yeah, and we'll see, now Mike Ross has gone for the EX headbutt one too many times because Xian read it correctly and then jumped backwards in order to avoid it and then punish him on the other side. So Mike has got to be play a little bit more conscious and think a little bit more about the decisions that he's making. Oh, wow, good block right there by Mike. That was tricky.
The cross up there. Okay, so Jen,
good
being a little
right
bit
there.
More aggressive overall here. He's starting to figure out.
Yes, Xian knows that because since he's playing a long set.
Does that work? Okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, he saw that one coming from a mile away.
He basically
away.
Took Ihana and made him stand back on the ground and just did that ultra to him.
Yeah, but you know, Mike has got some pretty good reads and reactions himself, so he may be able, if for example, he's walking backwards and Gen goes for a focus attack, Mike should be able to read it and then, that could be the end.
Oh, that might be it, yep.
Oh, no.
Okay, Mike, so now what we're going to be here at 5-3.
5-3, Gen.
So we're going to go into this next set. If you could say something, Mike Ross, what would you say right now, man? Yeah.
All right, there we go. Filipino champ stepping up to help his brother out and give him some words of wisdom. You know, lots of times it can be very helpful to have a second pair of eyes when you're fighting somebody because they can, you know, somebody with a, you know, with a more objective perspective can see things in your game as well as their game.
And let's just face it, man. Like, people want Mike Ross to stay in this here because
because if he can
they face off against him, maybe they can beat him.
Right.
You get rid of Xian here, and now you know everybody's got a better chance.
Exactly.
Xian is so dominant right now in the current Street Fighter metagame. Okay, and another kill right there.
Exactly. It's basically in everybody's best interest if Mike wins.
Yeah. Exactly.
But you know, right now it looks like.
Okay, this is starting to snowball, man. This is starting to get out of control pretty quick here. In fact, we might even see a perfect here from Gen.
Yeah, Mike got off to a very strong start, but it looks like Xian may have.
He's gotten dizzied here.
It looks
that
like
was
it's
a
download
perfect.
Complete.
Ouch.
So this is match point for Xian. The score is now 6-3. Mike has got to win 4 games in a row to stay alive here.
He is not allowed to make any more mistakes or Mike Ross's story ends right here.
Yeah. But now we'll see if Mike can hold it together, play patient. See, you know, at that point, neither of these guys have meter. Honda can just sit there and wait for Gen to come in and make a mistake.
This is very true. Yeah, Gen has to try to build some kind of
ground
here.
At this point, let's say that Gen just stands there and waits. Mike will win by timeout. So
this is true.
Gen is forced to make a move and forced to try to attack. So Honda can just sit on his life lead and play very conservatively.
All right, well, he's starting to get something done over here. But, another EX headbutt there, but it did not allow, it
right.
was not
so basically,
to punish there.
Yeah, exactly. So basically, Gen timed his jump in so that he would be able to block the EX headbutt.
Is he going to come back here? He's got Honda in the corner. Tried doing a focus and then canceling there, seeing if he couldn't bait anything out there from Mike Ross just there.
Yeah, but Mike still got the lead. He is in the corner. Ooh.
Oh.
Oh, that's... Okay, yeah, see, like, all it takes is one EX headbutt like that to basically reset the situation and the momentum, and then Mike can kind of inch his way out of the corner, and you'll see...
Oh, he's just kind of chipped that out with a 100-hand slap.
Yeah, see,
nicely done.
At that point, it looked like Xian was like, you know what, I'm just going to give this guy the round because it's better to just start the round fresh rather than, you know, be tempted to use some of your own bar or let Mike build up more bar than he's already got. But,
He did not connect! He can punish!
Yeah. So now... Since Xian mistimed his super, he is he's basically out of resources.
He might lose this one set here.
That could end up
the beginning of the comeback here for Mike Ross.
Right, yeah, that could end up costing him this game. Yeah, there we go. So Xian is kind of losing his patience a little bit and jumping in, but Mike uses his EX to get out of trouble. Oh, that's not good. Nice cross up there by Xian. Getting the momentum back. Mike's doing a good job of just playing defense and being patient. Xian uses some of his meter to get out, to basically reset the situation. Oh, that's not good.
Oh, nice,
that's
gonna connect.
Good damage right there. Mike has a tiny life lead, but he's gotta be very careful not to throw out the headbutt where Xian can see it coming, because okay. That was how he lost last time.
Now he's getting so low, he might just chip him out here with another 100 hand slab.
Right,
but he doesn't have to run in here. He can let Xian come to him.
There we go.
There we go. Nicely done.
Exactly. Lots of times when you have the lead, you know, you don't necessarily need to take any additional risk, and you can just kind of apply the mental pressure to them and force them to make a mistake. So now it's 6-4. It's still match point for Xian. Xian's got to just win two more rounds in order to send Mike home.
All right, he's once again
getting a lot of mileage out of that overhead.
Yeah, especially early on here. He's already got his ultra ready now, but I don't know if he's going to stop him this time around here. Another nice throw. And this is the part where Mike Ross is just not allowed to panic, you know, he has to.
Right.
Be absolutely patient. Now he's got Gen in the corner.
Yeah, but Gen has got. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, there it is.
Mike went in a little bit too hard right there. Maybe it would have been better to do more 100 hand slaps in order to build some more meter.
Yeah, and just keep him pushed into that corner and try to get some kind of control, you know, of that side of the screen there. Oh,
there we
nice
go.
EX okay. headbutt there.
Mike has started to make the adjustments necessary. It is still match point. Oh, that's not good. Match point for Xian. Oh, wow. Falls out. They fall out of the of Gen's uppercut. It just happens sometimes. Oh, no. Mike makes an execution error. That's going to hurt. But now
we got Gen at 4 at full bar here. Ultra and super.
Oh.
Gen still low here, but pushing forward.
Yeah.
And Mike Ross does not have any more super bar.
Right, and this is going to be the end. Oh, man.
Oh, man.
Well, that was good.
Xian, well done. Nicely done there. Wow.
Well,
that was a good match.
It was a good match.
Mike Ross started out really strong. I was saying, wait a minute, is he gonna win this whole thing here? Because that would be a crazy huge upset that we'd have here for the start of a fight night with the Street Fighter edition. But in the end, the proper adjustments were made to take Mike Ross out.
Yeah, I think the critical turning point of the match was when Xian was able to prevent Mike from building meter by doing his command grab for full screen, because remember he did ultra and then he did super to counter that, and that kind of was like the turning point where Mike was like, I think that kind of like got in Mike's head a little bit. But you know, the final score 7-4 7-4. So you know, Mike held zone, you know, I think really strong start here at ESGN Fight Night.
All right, let's go throw it to Frodan and see what the thoughts of these players are right now.
Thanks, Tasis. I'm joined by Mike Ross. Mike, you had a great start, but what happened?
He got into my head, because before we started this set, actually it was like a few hours ago, he said, I only have one advice for you if you play me. Don't ever whiff an Ochio after you land a headbutt on me. And I did it, and then he ultra'd me. And he just stared at me and said, I told you not to do that. And then I did it again, and he did it again. So I just lost it after that. I lost all my composure.
You had Xian go way back. You were hanging out with him in Singapore. You actually said that you discovered him before he became hot. So now that you've finally faced him in a tournament format, do you have any words for him?
He got lucky this time. So, you know, I hope he does well the rest of the tournament. If we run it back, I will play much smarter. I apologize, Xian, for being such a scrub against you.
Well, thank you, Mike. You gave it your best. That's all anybody can ask for. Do you have any final words and shouts before we let you go?
No, just thanks, everybody, for this opportunity, and I hope to someday compete here again.
Mike Ross, the People's Champ.
Oh, it's too bad. I'm sorry to see you go, Mike Ross. I was rooting for you, but in the end, Xian's just too good.
Yeah, Mike held his own. He did really well, but unfortunately, I guess we're going to have to see who Xian is going to be fighting next.
Yeah, let's go ahead and go to our wheel and find out who the next opponent is going to be for Xian on tomorrow's fight night.
Thanks so much, Tasteless and Gootecks. Xian, congratulations on your series. It started off pretty close. Can you talk to me about how the series went down for you?
I think this is my first time playing against Mike Ross and never in a tournament, so I got pretty nervous at the start. He got into my head. I'm glad I managed to make it through.
Oh, he got into your head in the beginning?
Yeah.
So then what was the big turning point, do you feel?
I think I started to get used to his playstyle, and eventually I did better.
All right, well, Xian's very adaptive. Let's find out if he can adapt to his second opponent. Now, he chose to fill up his spot as well as the empty spot of Mike Ross with two Filipino champs. Can you talk about why that is?
Because I stayed at his house before and I played with him before, and I think he's the easiest among everyone.
Well, let's find out if fate's gonna have it that way. Xian, go ahead and take your first spin.
I can't be that unlucky, right?
So this is what? That's half Filipino champ turns out here. Yeah. No kidding, man.
Oh my god, there's so many Filipino champs up there. Oh my god, it's gonna be Filipino champ! Oh!
Is Filipino champ. He has an opportunity to dethrone Xian and earn himself an extra 100. Good luck, Xian.
Thank you.
Back to you guys at the desk.
So we already had this epic match today. We got this sick rivalry coming up now. Tomorrow, I think this entire week is going to be epic.
Yeah, we are in for a real treat because tomorrow, two world champions are going to be squaring off here on ESGN Fight Night. It's going to be 2013 Street Fighter 4 winner Xian, who won tonight, going up against last year's Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 world champion, Filipino champ.
So don't miss it. We'll see you tomorrow for Gootecks and myself. Good night.
Tomorrow on Fight Night.
Oh my God.